Okay, so I'm gonna try to go over this calculation really quick. This is just a model, so it's a little, they collect data, they measure the pressure at different places, they find the pressure a human can take, and then they make a model from it, and that's that. Because it's really pretty complicated. So I'm gonna show you how to use the model, and I'm gonna show you one other thing. Okay, so the model is this right here. This is the range, the blast radius that you can be safe. It's this z times m to the 1/3 to the cube root power of m. I don't know, can you see that? Yeah, I think you can see that. Okay, so m is the mass of the mass, the it's actually the TNT equivalent mass of the thing. So C4 would be approximately the same mass as TNT, but it doesn't really matter. So I'm going to use a mass of 2 kilograms. Z is the distance factor. So if you want humans in cars, then Z would be 14.8. If you want humans that aren't in cars, there's a bigger number, like 22 or something. If you want other ammo, see, because this is a UN calculation, how close can explosives be to other things and be safe in case it explodes. If you want it next to ammo, then it'd have to be even smaller, okay? Because ammo is not going to have to get pretty close in order to actually blow up. Okay, so all we need to do is if we use 14.8 for traffic, that's just something they give us, and I'm going to use 2 kilograms for the mass, then I get a distance. But let me show you first. I know you guys like English, so I'm going to use English units. So let's say he estimated it at 4.5 pounds. Then there's 1 kilogram is equal to 2.2 pounds. So if I multiply 4.5 pounds by this fraction is one because these are the same thing. But the pound units cancel and I get around, it's really close to 2 kilograms. Yeah, I cheated. I went backwards. But we can do that, right? It's not real. So that's the mass of 2 kilograms. So now over here, I put in 14.8 was that z factor. 2 kilograms to the 1/3, and I get 18.6 meters. Now again, let's convert it. So here I have 18.64 meters. There's 3.3 feet in 1 meter, so the meters cancel, and I get 61 feet. So that's the radius. So the diameter would be 122 feet. In the script, it says 200, and we can adjust these numbers if you want, but you could say, oh, well, let's just be safe. It has to be over 100 feet, so let's go 200 feet. Because you do want a safety factor in. These are, you're estimating the mass, you're estimating the other things, so. Okay, now one other calculation. What about the pressure wave? So the explosive blows up, and it pushes the air, and this it makes this pressure wave, the shock wave. This is what really kills people. It turns out that humans can tolerate a PS a pressure about 45 PSI. That's the max pressure, roughly. So we want the pressure to be at a distance far enough away that the pressure to the explosion is 45 PSI. Okay, I kind of cheated here because it's hard to calculate these things, but I said, okay, let's say that the explosion is 1.5 billion newtons of force pushing. And as that gets further and further away, it's spread over a larger and larger area. So the pressure decreases because you're further away. That is true. The pressure does decrease as you get further away. So I can calculate the pressure as the force divided by the area, and the area is the radius of the circle, the surface area of a circle as you get further and further away. So it's 4 pi times the radius squared. So if I use that 1.5 billion newtons and I put in 20 meters, because I'm just going to round up 20 meters, then I get a pressure of, this is 3 times 10 to the fifth pascals, which is a newton per meter squared. You can convert that to PSI and it's 45 PSI. So I think that hopefully should be enough calculation. Oh, and I drew a picture of a van blowing up. R. Okay?